Hello students, I hope this video finds you in the best of health. You and your family must be safe and healthy. I am sure most of you must have started cultivating the habit of reading. Another good habit is listening. The core skills to language are reading, writing, listening and speaking. You must listen actively too. Listening helps you understand the other person's outlook. Remember, if you don't listen, no one will listen to you. Coming back to civics, we have learned so far that diversity is not always celebrated. Diversity is the source of discrimination. Since we cannot accept that people are different from us, we form certain opinions about them. We start seeing them as inferior. That is prejudice. Then we learnt about stereotypes. When we fix people into one image, we create a stereotype. We also learnt that children with special needs are also discriminated against. Today, we are going to continue with the same chapter and we are going to learn about inequality. The word itself is suggestive. It comprises of two formations of words, which is in and equality. It means that when people are not considered equal because of their financial condition, because of poverty, because they are poor, it results in inequality. When people are discriminated against due to their economic backgrounds, it is inequality. Let's know more about it. People who are poor and they don't have enough money to meet their basic requirements of a lifestyle, you know, people consider them as inferior. They experience discrimination in many areas, for example, hospitals, schools. Some people may experience both kinds of discrimination. They are poor and they belong to groups whose culture is not valued. Let's understand discrimination now. Groups of people who may speak a certain language, follow a particular religion, live in a specific region may be discriminated against as their customs or practices may be seen as inferior. There are many reasons why they can be discriminated. People discriminate when they act on their prejudice or stereotypes. We have learned about stereotypes and prejudice in our previous video. And in fact, diversity can be a source of discrimination. It is funny that people who are engaged in activities which help us to groom ourselves, which help us to keep our surroundings clean, our houses clean, are faced with a lot of discrimination. So people who are engaged in activities like cleaning, washing, cutting hair, picking garbage are seen as tasks that are of less value. And people who do this work are seen as dirty or impure. This belief is an important aspect of the caste system that still exists in India. Communities, groups of people are placed in a sort of ladder where each caste was either above or below the other. Let's turn our focus onto a group of people who have been discriminated against since time immemorial, the Dalits. Caste rules were set which did not allow the so-called untouchables to take on work other than what they were supposed to do. For example, some groups were forced to pick up garbage and remove dead animals from the village, but they were not allowed to enter the homes of the upper castes. Or take water from the village well, or even enter temples. Their children could not sit next to the people of other castes in school. Now, you will ask me, what is upper caste? Those who place themselves at the top of this particular ladder of the caste system called themselves upper caste and saw themselves as superior. The groups who were placed at the bottom of the ladder were seen as unworthy or useless and were called untouchables. Dalit is a term that people belonging to so-called lower castes used to address themselves. The government refers to this group of people as scheduled castes. What you see on this slide is the Hindu caste system. At the top are the Brahmins. They are considered the people who are closest to God, and they are the people who perform rituals. Next to the Brahmins are the Kshatriyas. They are the warrior class. They are known to defend the country. After them are the Vaishyas, the Banya, or the business class. They are the people who do business. And then they are the Shudras, the lowest class of farmers, and those who serve the other classes. Below these are the untouchables, also known as Dalits. One such person who faced the caste system was Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. He is considered the father of the constitution. He belonged to the Mahar caste, which was considered untouchable. He faced this discrimination at an early age of 9 years. Imagine how difficult it would be if people could not move easily from one place to another. How insulting and hurtful it is to have people move away, refuse to touch you or allow you to drink water or not allow you to drink water from the same source as they do. It denies the Dalits respect and dignity given to others. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, popularly also known as Baba Saheb Ambedkar, is the father of the Indian Constitution. He is also the best known leader of the Dalits. He fought for the rights of the Dalit community. In fact, like I told you earlier, he was born into the Mahar caste, which was considered as untouchable. He was the first person from his caste who completed his college education and went to England to become a lawyer. Let's know more about Baba Saheb. Later in life, he converted to Buddhism in search for a religion that treated all members equally. He believed that Dalits must fight the caste system and work towards a society based on respect, not just for a few, but for all persons. We have learnt in the previous chapter how the whole of India came together to drive the British back out of our nation. However, along with the struggle of freedom within the people of India, the Dalits were fighting for their right to equality. Dalits, tribals and peasants fought against the inequalities they experienced in their lives. What Dalits fought for are entry into temples, women demanded right to education as men, they wanted to release themselves from the grasp of moneylenders and the high interest rates they were charged. What you see on your screen is the first page of our Indian Constitution that clearly states that all Indians are entitled to equality of status and opportunity. It is known as the Preamble to the Constitution of India, which is a brief introductory statement that sets out guidelines which guide the people of the nation and to present the principles of the Constitution. The Preamble to the Constitution. When India became a nation in 1947, our leaders too were worried about how the different kinds of inequalities existed in our society. That is the reason why they set out with a goal in the constitution to ensure that the people of India were treated equally. Everyone had equal rights and opportunities. Untouchability is seen as a crime and has been legally abolished by law. That means if you discriminate against someone, you could be legally punished by law. Well, the intention of the members who chalked the constitution was very simple. The writers of the constitution said that respect for diversity was a significant element in ensuring equality. People must have the freedom to follow their religion, speak their language, celebrate their festivals, and express themselves freely. They said that no one religion or festival should become compulsory for all to follow. They also said that the government must treat everybody and all religions equally. Now let's understand how India became a secular country. When people of different religions and faiths have the freedom to practice and follow their religion without any fear of discrimination, that is how a country becomes a secular country. This is as an important element of our unity, that we all live together and respect one another. That is what the people who framed the constitution intended to do. Even though these ideals, these objectives are very, very clearly mentioned, enshrined in our constitution, inequalities still exist today in our society. You may be seeing so many examples around you where people are discriminated against. In fact, in our own households, you know, the servants who work for us, they are never allowed an equal opportunity like us. Equality is a value that we have to keep striving for, which means we have to keep on working towards equality and not something which will happen automatically. Well, that's the end of this chapter, Chapter 2, Diversity and Discrimination. Thank you for listening. And below is the link to all NCERT ebooks. So you stay home and stay safe. Bye.